What's up, guys? Jay Rocky from the Web3 Experience podcast here. So today I'm going to be showing you how to bridge your Ethereum Layer 1 NFT to Optimism using the Optimism NFT Bridge from the Quix marketplace. And of course, what would a Jay Rocky video be without qualifying for a free NFT? So then after we bridge, we're going to go pick up our OP Bridge or NFT. And then of course, we're going to go to Quix and naturally check the price. If you want to follow along, I included all of the links that I just showed you in the video description below. Okay, so let's head over to the Optimism NFT Bridge to get started. In order to bridge, we're going to need two things. Number one, the contract address on Ethereum Layer 1. And number two, the token ID. And so the easiest place to find this is, since it's on Ethereum L1, you're probably using OpenSea anyway. So you should head to your profile, find the NFT that you want to bridge. Go to the NFTs page, scroll down, click details, and here you'll find the contract address. You'll click contract address. It'll take you to Etherscan. You can click copy, go back to the bridge, paste this address in. We'll go back to OpenSea, and in the same place that you found the contract address, right below it, you'll find the token ID 6207. So we'll go ahead and we'll type in 6207. And so in this case, it's not recognizing that I own it. And so the rule of thumb again in Web3 is, when in doubt, just refresh the page. So go ahead, give it a refresh, and there it is, Bridge to Optimism. So we'll click the Bridge to Optimism. We'll have to approve the collection, sign the transaction. And of course, as usual, I'm on Optimism, right? So we'll need to switch to Ethereum mainnet. So switch networks. We'll sign the transaction. Looks like our approved transaction went through. Another transaction will automatically pop up. This one is to actually bridge. We'll sign this transaction. That gas cost of $6 hurts my soul, by the way. And after we bridge, I'll explain to you the benefits of why we're bridging to Optimism in the first place. So we'll sign this transaction. And then once you sign the transaction, it'll say Bridge NFT, your bridge transaction is being processed. Please allow up to 15 minutes for the transfer to finalize. While we wait for our NFT to bridge over, I wanted to explain to you why I trade on Layer 2. So of course, down here we have our fearless leaders, David and Ryan from Bankless, trading L1 NFTs with L2 gas fees. Let me think about it. Well, transaction fees are 20 times cheaper, and transaction speeds are 100 times faster. Well, no brainer, right? And as an added bonus, we're also about to go and collect our free NFT for bridging over to Layer 2. This Bridger NFT also entitles you to OP rewards on the Quix marketplace, which I'll show you how to get at the end. But before we do that, I'm going to show you just how valuable cheaper transaction fees can be. Okay, so here I've modeled out a scenario where we stay on Layer 1 and trade this NFT versus a scenario where we go to Layer 2 and start trading this NFT. So the purchase price of the NFT is the same, of course, on both platforms, $70. Let's say our NFT appreciates by 5%, right, on both platforms. That would mean that we're now able to sell it for $73.50. on both platforms, right? Now on Layer 1, we would actually lose 87 cents on this trade. Meanwhile, on Layer 2, we would actually profit $3.30. So what's the difference, right? And of course, it's the transaction fee. So you're buying it for the same amount, but on Layer 1, the transaction fee is $4.37, where on Layer 2, the transaction fee is only 20 cents. So the total cost on Layer 1 is $74.37. Meanwhile, the total cost on Layer 2 is $70.20. Now, imagine you live your entire life trading on Layer 1 instead of Layer 2. Over 100 trades, you would actually lose $87. Meanwhile, on Layer 2, you would profit $330. So there's a pretty big difference there, right? Now, of course, I excluded marketplace fees and creator fees from the calculations, but on both platforms, those are going to be pretty similar. You may have also noticed that I didn't take into account the bridge fee that we paid on Layer 1 to bridge to layer two for simplicity purposes. And that's because we're going to more than make up for that with the free NFT that we're about to claim and the OP rewards that this NFT entitles us to. Let's head back to the bridge to see if we successfully got our NFT to the Optimism layer two. And it looks like we have status complete. We can click view NFT. This will take us directly to the Quix NFT marketplace, where we can now see the NFT that was previously on layer one is now on Optimism layer two, and it's owned by you. Let's go get our free NFT. I included all of these links, by the way, in the video description. So we're going to head over here, OP Bridger. We're going to click Mint NFT. We're going to sign the transaction. Well, of course, you need to switch back to Optimism because we are now on Optimism again. So we'll switch networks and then we'll sign the transaction. It looks like our transaction went through. We can click View Our NFT. It'll take you back to your homepage. And you can see we have the OP Bridger NFT within our wallet. Now that we have our free Bridger NFT, I remember saying something about this now entitling us to OP rewards. So let's go see what that's all about. We can go up here and we click stats and we can see all of the collections and we find one that we're interested in buying, right? We can click buy now. And if you see a little spitty bar right here, most likely I've found in past experiences, it's because I have too many Quix tabs opened. So you should close all of them out except for one, and this OP rewards will pop up. And it looks like if we buy this NFT, we'll be entitled to 5.5 OP just for buying the NFT, automatically airdropped it to our wallet. If we click this little down arrow, we can see the details here. This Quix OP reward is just standard marketplace rewards. You don't have to have anything special to get that. This OP OG bonus is actually given to you because you own that Bridger NFT. Also, you qualify for this bonus if you've earned any other NFT from Quix, like this OP Orca. This OP Orca, you actually had to have one ETH or over one ETH trading volume on Quixotic, and then they gave it to you for free. So if you were an early adopter of Quixotic and you spent over one ETH, it looks like they just gave you 0.226 ETH for free. And that's it. If you like the video, you can subscribe above. There'll be plenty more like this one. And also, I've linked the Optimism Quest tutorial series that you see here. So if you're interested in some more free NFTs, you can check this one out as well. Thanks for watching, guys.